daddy weight.
So, hopefully you can see me, which you can, but I was pulling my microphone out of my bag, and this happened. And this is really dirty, but microphone came off. The microphone's not broke. The microphone is not broken. It's the stand. So, I don't know how this sounds. I'm just gonna kind of rest it in the stand where it's supposed to be. And we'll go from there. But anyway, the purpose of this video today is to show you guys my new meal plan, my new, that I will possibly be doing for my prep for the show in June. Now, this is not set in stone or anything, so I am going to kind of do like a trial before the Arnold and kind of see how I feel. And so yeah, we're going to go over that in a minute. So I apologize if the microphone is all messed up in this, but I'm going to do my best to kind of not shake it at all. But I just kind of set this up to kind of get the thumbnail, and I'm going to go through it with you guys in a minute. But what I want to do is I want to just talk about it for a second about what I'm gonna be eating, why I'm gonna be doing it that way, and if I'm gonna keep it the way it is. So I'm just gonna be doing this for 4 days, for Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday. I'm gonna do it all like this, like I'm about to show you. So the first thing that I've got is, I've got tilapia, obviously. Hang on. I've got tilapia fillets right there. I've got Synthesix isolate that I'm gonna be using. I've got chicken, whole eggs, steam fresh veggies. I've got some steaks and egg whites and aminos, obviously, all day, every day. So this is kind of the summary of everything. There is one more thing that I'll get to in a minute with this, but I'm gonna be meal prepping my entire 4 days right now, so I kind of want to go through that and show you guys what I do as far as that. So I'm going to be showing you guys the MyFitnessPal part of this at the end, I guess I'll do that. So the first thing that I really want to do is I'm going to be cooking steak, whole eggs. I'm going to be boiling eggs, and I'm going to throw my chicken in the crock pot in a minute. So what I'm going to do first is what I'm going to start the hard-boiled eggs part. Now, why I'm doing hard-boiled whole eggs, and this is gonna be cooking my meal one. I'm doing the hard-boiled eggs because my meal one is going to be at work, and well, my meal one, two, and three is gonna be at work. So I am not gonna be cooking whole eggs at work. I'm not gonna fry some whole eggs, put them in a Tupperware, bring them to work. So I'm gonna cook the whole eggs first. I'm gonna hard boil them just so I can take them with me like that. So, got a pot here. I'm gonna fill it up with water. But first, what I like to do when I hard boil the eggs is take the eggs out. I'm gonna take the eggs out and I'm gonna put in 2 eggs for Sunday, 2 for Monday, 2 Tuesday, and 2 Wednesday. So, 2 for Sunday, 2 for Monday, 2 for Tuesday, and two for Wednesday. Now I've got all those in there and I'm gonna fill it up with water, and you kind of want the water to be just over the top of the eggs. So we want them just like that, just over the top of the eggs. Now I won't focus on them, hang on. Just over the top of the egg, so none of the eggs is coming out of the water. So I'm gonna turn this rear on like medium high to high and wait for it to boil, and then we're gonna get those going first. All right, the next thing is gonna be the steaks. Now I have four steaks here. And like I said in the beginning of the video, I got these at a supermarket. I wanted to go to this place, it's called Meatland, and they do like steaks, beef, they do fish and chicken and all sorts of stuff for a better price, and you get more out of it. So they didn't have, per pound, they had $8 per pound for steaks, and I have one here for, where is it? This one's 1.13 pounds and it's $6. So I went with a couple of these, and I know that I've done it a couple times already. 0.75 is usually about 6 ounces. So a lot of these are a pound or just under a pound, so I can get my 6 ounces out of them. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna be cooking all of them on my frying pan. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna sit here with my knife. I'm gonna open the package like this. And what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna continue to trim the fat off of these the best I can. And then I'm gonna cut them into little tiny, not too tiny, but little strips. Two of them cut up right now that I'm gonna start frying on the frying pan. So they're not too small. They're pretty good size. So I'm gonna get these on here. And then I'm going to finish cutting up the rest. Alright, so these have been boiling for about a minute or two, and I'm gonna let them boil for 15 minutes. I've just finished cutting the rest of the steaks up, and these ones are about to, they're ready to flip. So let me take the hood off. And now, just flip each one. Cooking, I'm going to start my chicken. Now this chicken is going to be the only thing that I don't weigh out and put in a container today. Tomorrow morning I will put that in a container when I wake up and I'm about to go to work and I'm getting everything ready. Then I'm going to take it out, cut it, measure it, and then just throw it in a container for that time. So I've got my chicken here. Cut this open. This one's pretty lean. I try to buy like the really lean ones so I don't have to like trim if any of the fat off. I can just rip it off. So I'm just putting the entire chicken breast in there. And then, like I said, in the morning, I will cut it to weigh 6 inches. 6 inches, yeah. Weigh 6 inches. 6 ounces. So yeah, these are pretty lean ones, I'm glad. So I'll put those in there, and I'll put it on a low heat for 8 hours. And I'll throw some of this kickin' chicken seasoning on there. And I see that the steak's probably done. So I'm gonna throw some of the seasoning on here. So since I don't have to worry about the chicken anymore, I can just worry about the steak, eggs. Eggs are probably almost done. And I have to cook some rice too. So I am going to put this in a strainer and then throw it in a bowl and then start the next round. I'm gonna throw on the steaks again. There's a lot in this one, so. Now I'm gonna take off my eggs and throw them in a container. This is the container that I'm going to have my eggs and my steak in. And this is the container that I'm going to throw the rest of them for the rest of the week in. And honestly, I don't feel like filling up and doing all my weighing and all that stuff right now. So what I'm just going to do is I'm going to have 3 separate containers for meal 1, 2, and 3 for those days at work. And then I'm just going to throw in my my food and then wait until the next day to bring my containers back home, empty them out, fill them back up in the morning when I weigh those foods. So I'm gonna have 2 of my eggs are gonna go right in this one. So I've got 2 eggs in this one. That's where the steak's gonna go. So every morning I'll come downstairs and I'll throw 2 eggs in here and I'll measure out my steak, which I can do right now, and I'll throw it in this container while the other steak is cooking. Now what I'm gonna do now is I'm gonna cook the rice that I need for the 4 days. So I'm gonna empty this out and that's what I'm gonna cook the rice in. The tricky thing about rice is we wanna do 1 cup of rice cooked in 2 of my meals. So 1 cup non-cooked is really 2 cups cooked when you kind of measure it out, or like 1 cup and 3/4 or something like that. So since I need 2, 4, 6, 8 cups, I'm going to do 3 cups of rice and I'm going to do 2.5 cups of water. And we're gonna hope that that turns out all right. So I got my measuring cup right here. Fill it up. There's 1 cup. There's 2 cups and 1/2 cup. All right, 2.5 cups. Bring it over. Now with rice, you want to have the burner boiling or on high, so it boils the water. Then when the water is boiling, you put the rice in, you wait for it to return to a boil, and then you either put it on low or like a medium heat where it's not gonna overflow. So we're gonna wait for that. I'm gonna flip the steak, and then we're gonna measure out 6 ounces of steak for my container meal 1. We'll be right back. my scale here. I'm gonna turn that on. Wait for it to zero out, and then I'm gonna put on my eggs with the container, and then I'm gonna press on again. It's gonna zero it out, so I can just measure the steak. So it's at a zero now, and I want 6 ounces of steak. So there's 1.7, 2.7, 4.2, 5.1, 5.5, 5.9. I'm just gonna leave it at that. And this is what it's going to look like. My 5.9. Have my 2 eggs and my 6 ounce steak. So that one is prepping, or is all done. Water's boiling, so I gotta throw the rice in, and that's gonna be done in a second, so I'm gonna take that off. But first, I'm gonna throw in the rice. There's 1 cup. Cups. Three cups. Alright, now I'm going to wait for that to boil a little more, and then we're going to cover it and turn it on low. Alright, I took it off the heat, waiting for that burner to go back down to warm lowish, and we'll put that back on. Now this is all done, I'm gonna throw it in the strainer and then into that bowl. And then we're gonna throw that into a bigger container, which I have right here. I'm gonna throw all the steak in this. And I'm just going to, like I said, in the morning, just weigh it out, throw it in another container and be done with it. So we're gonna wait on the rice, and then we're gonna go over the other things that I have for after. So while that's cooking, that rice is cooking, that's the last thing we have to cook tonight besides the chicken, but that's gonna take throughout the night, so we don't have to worry about that. So what else do I have? What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna be measuring a cup of the rice, and I'm gonna be putting that in the container. 2 containers for tomorrow that I'm gonna set out. They got them right here. I've got 2 containers right here that I'm gonna throw 1 cup of rice in each. And then in the morning, I'm going to be putting 6 ounces of chicken in both of those. So that'll make one meal, is the meal that I have already, the 2 whole eggs with 6 ounces of steak. And then the next meal will be 6 ounces of chicken and 1 cup of rice. Now this is a low carb day. When I do a high carb day, I'm going to be having 2 cups of rice and then 2 cups of rice after that. So I'm gonna keep it low carb until the Arnold though. So I'm not really worried about that. So that's gonna be, first meal is gonna be the steak and eggs. Then the next 2 meals are going to be chicken and rice. Now, after that, what I'm going to be having, one of those will be my pre-workout meal. Now, besides that, post-workout, what I'm going to be doing is I'm going to be having a Synthesix Isolate shake right here. My Synthesix Isolate shake with, I'm going to be doing 1 packet of these cream of wheat. So I'm going to be having that post-workout. Now, before bed, you guys will see that I had the egg whites out here. I'm gonna do a cup of egg whites before I go to bed. Now, what that's going to help me with is just having protein while I am going to sleep, and that's going to prevent me from storing any leftover carbs or fats post-workout. I should burn through everything throughout the day post-workout, and then my last meal of the day will just be the protein. So I'm gonna go over the macros with you guys real quick. Let me pull it up. Oh, and what else am I gonna be having with my chicken and rice is some veggies. So I have like these mixed veggies here, and they're just the steam fresh carrots, beans, and broccoli and stuff like that. So I can switch up. I normally just have green veggies with it, so I can really have whatever veggies I want. Okay, so the steak, 6 ounces of steak. I just kind of fill it up in my Fitness Pal, which you guys have seen like a ton of times before. So 6 ounces of steak, 2 large eggs, whole eggs, 2 scoops of Synthesis isolate, cream of wheat, cup of egg whites, 1 cup of, or well, 2 cups total in the day of rice, and 12 ounces total in the day of chicken breast. And that's gonna bring my macros to 104 carb, which is 100 carb. I like to keep it as a low day for me. 35 fat. My only fat throughout the day is really gonna be barely any in the chicken, barely any in the synthesis isolate. So most of it's gonna be coming from breakfast, and that's gonna help me burn it off throughout the day. And then 220 protein, which is a good number for me. Now, I was hesitant first to use the steak and the eggs because of the fats, but when I plugged it in and looked at the macros, I'm like, 35 grams of fat is really nothing. I prepped on 50 grams of fat and got in great shape, so I'm gonna keep it at that. So that's what I'm pretty much, I'm trying to think of what else I had to talk about, but that was pretty much it. So what I'm gonna do, I'm going to stir this rice real quick, make sure it doesn't stick to the pan. There's a ton of rice. I think it's done. Yeah, we're gonna say it's done. All right, so I'm gonna turn this off, and I'm gonna be measuring 2 cups a day in here. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna throw 1 cup in each one of these containers, 1 cup, and then I'm gonna throw the rest of it in a separate container to just measure in the morning and take with me. All right, so I'm hoping that that amount of rice in there right now is going to give me another 4 cups. And it's really not looking like it. So, I don't know. I think I have a backup plan. I think. Nope, no backup plan. So I might just have to make some more, or get an Uncle Ben's bag of brown rice. I don't know. I don't know what I'll do, but I'll leave that for Wednesday to worry about. So I'll just remember next time. That's kind of why I wanted to do it now, to remember that I'll probably end up doing like I did 3 cups of dry rice. So I'll probably do 4 or 5. We'll see how much I have left over come then. So I'm gonna close those up, throw the rest of that in a container, and be done with it. All right, so to cap it off, we have the rice left over that I'm going to be prepping with the rest of the week. But for tomorrow, I have my 1 cup of rice here that I'm gonna throw 6 ounces of chicken in there, 6 ounces of chicken in there with my cup of rice. Then I'm gonna go over here. I have my eggs done for the rest of the week, my steak for the rest of the week. And then I have tomorrow's meal 1, 6 ounces of steak, 2 whole eggs. And then I have the chicken in there. that I'm just going to be taking out tomorrow morning before work and cutting it and measuring it 6 ounces to throw in the ones that I have over there. So guys, all in all, this was super, super easy. Literally only cooking one, two, four things, counting the chicken. And what I'm gonna do with fish, I know you guys have, I talked about fish in the beginning. Here and there, I'll probably switch it out. Towards the end of prep, I will, you know, talk about how I'm gonna change to just fish instead of chicken. And then I'll probably switch out my steak and eggs for just steak or egg whites. I'm not positive what I'm gonna do yet, but I wanted to share this with you, kind of give you my thoughts on it and talk about maybe I'll be doing this. So I'm gonna be doing this for the next 4 days, see how I feel, see how I digest, if I feel a little bit leaner, if I feel leaner and fuller, just kind of, you know, how I feel about it. So I'm gonna be talking about that. Thursday when I travel, so I'll be vlogging the entire Arnold. So I think that is it. So thank you all for watching. I hope this wasn't painful for you. And so I'll see you guys. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna probably vlog. I leave 8:30 in the morning on Thursday morning. So I'll be vlogging all that and talk to you guys then.